My name is Leela Ramdean. I'm the chair of the Catholic Commission for Social Justice in Trinidad and Tobago. I'm also a member of the Greater Caribbean for Life, which was established after a meeting in October 2011 here in Madrid that was organized by the community San Egidio. And we felt that we needed to focus on collaborating more within the Greater Caribbean region, which comprised 25 countries, including some of the Spanish-speaking countries in the Caribbean and the 13 English-speaking countries. So the Greater Caribbean for Life was formed. I'm also an attorney at law, and I returned to Trinidad and Tobago after living in the UK for a number of years to try to help to reverse the trend of all the negative things that's going on there. It's a difficult situation because the trend, there's been an upward trend, an upsurge of crime, of violent crime over the last few decades, and the way in which our politicians in the region have sought to deal with it really is to implement the death penalty. Since 1993, there's been a case in Jamaica, the Pratt & Morgan and the Attorney General in Jamaica. The Privy Council, the 27 countries that still use the Privy Council, the Privy Council made it clear, if people have been on death row for more than 5 years, it's cruel and inhuman treatment to keep them there and to hang them after that. And so the ruling is that they must be commuted to life. Their sentence must be commuted to life. In reality, the effect of that is that most Caribbean countries cannot implement the death penalty. So although our politicians, every time there's an upsurge of crime, will say to the public, we're going to resume hanging, the general public really not aware enough to realize that that's just, as we could say, old talk, that they can't really do it. Now, to nullify the effect of Pratt & Morgan, some of our countries have, like Barbados, and now Jamaica has got a Charter of Rights, the way to nullify it is to amend your constitution. Trinidad and Tobago tried doing that in January, February of this year by bringing a bill to Parliament, but opposition didn't support it and they need a special majority to pass it. And that is sad because in the views of people like myself who are trying to work towards abolishing the death penalty, what it's doing is it's just hyping up people's expectation that hanging will be the solution when we know hanging won't be. And we've had a recent report from the UNDP, United Nations Development Programme, in February 12th it was launched, called Human Development and the Shift to Better Citizen Security. And that report really is an excellent report, and it lists some of the key recommendations that our country should be focusing on. Not only death penalty, but how do we prevent crime? Because really at the end of the day, what we want to do is to reduce crime. Sadly, like the Prime Minister of Trinidad and Tobago has made it clear, that the death penalty is a weapon in her arsenal in the fight against crime. That's really taking it, in my view, to a different level, and really taking away, distracting from the real issues. Why is it that we can't control crime? Why is it that we have only about 10 to 14% detection rate? Now, that UNDP report highlights three things that will reduce crime. The severity of the penalty. Well, we know the severity is death, can't be more severe than that, but that hasn't worked because there's still crime in spite of that. Swiftness and certainty. If you know that you're only 10% likely to be caught, there is no certainty. And there's a huge backlog of cases, so there's no swiftness. We need governments in our region who are courageous, who are determined to reduce crime and not to play politics with people's lives, which is what's happening at the moment, unfortunately.